Get ready to match the stars from Password Plus. Tom Kennedy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from the Lawrence Welk Show, Gail Farrell, McLean Stevenson, and George Dudevant, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Roberts.
Yeah, that's, is that a combo? Hello there. Yeah.
Wow.
We are a combo.
Right. Yeah.
You did it again. Throw me the box of Kleenex.
I'm with Charles. I don't like sissies.
Who's a sissy?
That's Sissy Pink, ain't it?
She'll probably be doing the show a lot now, huh?
Yes, she will.
Just once a year to almost like a regular basis,
I suppose.
If
right,
right. Yeah, I'll be in your chair.
Congratulations.
That is so pretty.
Thank you very much.
That is very nice.
I could
nice.
Use that in the bedroom.
You got five of those blue sweaters. That's great, isn't it?
No, I didn't. I don't have five of these. What I told you was...
What?
I got five sweaters. I played in five golf tournaments this year and got five tee prizes. So I can do this show 5 days in a row without doubling up now.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay, well, you will be doing it 5 days in a row.
Yeah.
And that's our good fortune. All right, shall we have a go at it by meeting our two players here, Tom Davidson and Staff Sergeant Lois Hobby. Remember, Tom is a graduate of the Air Force Academy. He's married, has no children, right? And what do you do for a living now?
I'm a builder.
You're a builder. All that money went down the drain, huh? Trained you to be a pilot or a navigator or a bombardier or something or a flight engineer or whatever, and now you're building houses.
They only had a 5-year term on my soul, and I repaid them.
I see. Okay, Tom. Now, Lois, you've been in 7 years.
Right.
And how long have you been in grade?
Let's see, I made rank November 1st.
Just about, yeah.
2 years.
Yeah. You about due. What's your next step up?
Be tech sergeant.
Tech sergeant.
Mm-hmm.
Shall we make her a tech sergeant?
Yeah.
Hey! All right. So this is game number two. Last game, Tom, A or B?
A.
Ugly Alfreya is really ugly. In school, she was voted most likely to appear on the cover of blank.
Also, Alfreya, I've always been through.
UL. It's a totally synthetic contrived name because when we were using names, we were offending some people.
Oh, I see.
So now we made up a name.
No one would possibly have a name like that.
No one has that name.
But if you do have one out there, you're going to hear from him.
Right. Or her.
She has was voted most likely to appear on the cover of.
Right. This is something that I've never revealed to those of you who watch from at home, but no one on the panel wears anything from the waist down. That's it. They just come out here with these tops, and they look very neat and put together. But from the waist down, it's zip. Hello, Tom. Ugly Alfreya is really ugly. In school, she was voted most likely to appear on the cover of...
Field and Stream.
Field and Stream.
What did you say?
Wonderful answer.
Field and Stream.
Oh, Field and Stream. Isn't that clever, Tom?
That is clever.
Yeah.
I wish I had been that clever. I just came up with dumb old Popular
Mechanics. Popular Mechanics, another good possibility there.
Field and Stream.
Four-leaf clover.
Ireland.
Wrong. Mad Magazine.
Yeah. That's another good one. May I point out, in the rules of the game, only one-word clues are permitted.
Oh, sorry about that.
Four-leaf clover is not a one-word clue. Hello, Charles.
Just was seeing if you were watching. Oh, again, the right
answer. Oh, wow. Field and Stream. Charles, you have a way with words.
I continue matching the wrong people.
In school, she was voted most likely to appear on the cover of...
Brett and I had the same idea.
Mad Magazine. Well, that was another good possibility. Yeah.
This is a little-known publication that is very popular around my hometown, being a farm community. It's called Hog Life.
Hog Life.
Hog Life. Oh,
Joyce.
That's terrible.
No.
I said Builder's Manual.
Builder's Manual.
I thought they could do a whole reconstruction job.
Tell us, sir, since you're the authority on hogs, they don't like to wallow in mud. They'd rather be clean than dirty, wouldn't they, sir?
No, as a matter of fact, that is wrong, Gene. Hogs do wallow in the mud because hogs have hair on them. Do you really care about this?
Yes,
a lot
I do.
Of people don't.
Right. I care about it.
Okay, well, hogs have hair.
Yeah.
And any hair-bearing animal, such as an elephant, has hair. A lot of people didn't know that elephants have hair.
They have very fuzzy hair.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, very thin, fuzzy hair.
Bristly is what I call it.
Well, hog's hair is bristly.
Yes.
Bristles.
But an elephant's hair is bristly, too.
It is.
From the movie Who Cares?
Yes.
But in any event, hogs like to get down in the mud because it keeps that hair soft and keeps flies and stuff off of them.
Uh-huh. Okay, thank you very much.
I think that people want to write in and ask about their animals. They should write to Dr. McLean.
Uh-huh.
They should give the box number. He is fat. His books on animals, the cat books alone, are brilliant.
Right. Yes, there are instructions in how to build a house for your cat.
Uh-huh. It was...
Litter condominium.
I just got a book yesterday. Yes. It's called 100 Things to Do with a Dead Cat.
Don't want to hear about it. Here we go. Grace said, are you ready, Lois?
Grace?
This is your Grace said, my husband is very depressed about his work. Very depressed about his work. He's in over his head. What makes it really depressing is that he works in a blank.
Uh-huh.
He's in over his head. Yeah, I know it because you were listening to somebody else. You weren't paying attention. We're ready. My husband is very depressed about his work. He's in over his head. What makes it really depressing is that he works in a blank.
A swimming pool.
What does he do in that swimming pool?
Well, he builds swimming pools.
He builds swimming pools.
Right.
And he's in over his head. All right. Show her a wonderful answer.
All right, here it comes. Wonderful answer number one. Take one. Sewer.
What do you say there?
Fabulous answer number two.
Sewer, right.
He was in the fertilizer business. He had a manure plant.
Uh-huh. It'd be terrible to be in over your head there. Gail?
This is the uptown version of a sewer, isn't it?
Sanitation plant. Uh-huh. Yep. Sewer is different from sanitation plant.
I will show my answer, but just for those folks that did want to write down the number on that hog life thing, I would like to get letters from you because a lot of people don't know that you can do interesting things with hog hair.
Oh, really?
You can do macrame with hog hair. I have a lot of macrame hog hair.
Macrame with hog hair.
Hang plants with hog hair.
You hang the plants with them. Isn't that interesting?
Yes.
Gross.
There's actually people that do-it-yourself vasectomies will take by braiding their legs and using hog hair can affect a happy life.
All right.
But my answer, nonetheless, is sewer.
Sewer. Wonderful answer.
Could I ask you a professional question?
Sure. As long as it has
farmer,
to do with your hog.
Well, it doesn't, but it has to do with farms. Do you put manure in your strawberries?
Only after I pick them.
There you go.
All right, Joyce, show us your head.
Sewer,
everybody had sewer there. So 1-0 to score in favor of Tom at the end of round one. Now this for you, if you please. Here we go. Round two. Tom, you're ahead. That means you have to go first.
B. Okay.
Everyone except Charles will play. Now, you've all heard of the song T for Two.
Oh, sure. T for Two, Two for T, U for me.
No request, please.
Oh.
Well, Loose Linda wrote a new song. It's called Blank for Six.
Okay. I'm still hung up on the previous.
Okay, Tom. You've heard of the song T for Two? Loose Linda wrote a new song. It's called Blank for Six.
Tricks.
Tricks for Six.
Tricks for Six.
Apparently the audience doesn't understand you, Tom. But I do.
Tricks for Six, huh?
Yeah, right.
I was still on that sewer question, the previous one, and I came up with Slop for Six.
Slop for Six.
Yeah, uh-huh. Well, if you use the right spices.
Yes. All right.
Well, Joyce and I were talking before the show, and she was talking to me about her premarital activities, so I said sex for sex.
Really?
Oh, whoa, a pet who tells everything.
Loose Linda wrote a new song. It's called Blank for Six.
Sex for Six.
All right.
Oh.
All right. I was just wondering what your interpretation of tricks for six was. Oh, all right. We'll just keep marching right on ahead here. Okay, McLean.
Yeah, well, I'm kind of shocked by the whole question. So I really,
I find it, I'm kind of a closet on this sort of thing. You know what
have
I mean?
We offended you?
No, I just find it
I hope
spicy,
we've offended
but I'm trying
you.
To act like I'm...
Oh, he's so great.
I said six, but I can't believe that anybody would participate in that.
All right, Joyce.
I feel so sorry for him.
How sorry do you feel?
You feel sorry enough, too. No, all right, sex is her answer. So we come to Lois's final question here in round two.
That was hard.
The coach said...
Coach?
The coach said, I can tell that that guy's not an athlete. He's wearing his blank on his head. Come on, Joyce. You got all those kids in your family, all those athletes, and you're an athlete.
Oh, one of those?
No clues, please.
Yes. Sure. You can say six for six. You can say that. I can tell you.
The coach said, I can tell that guy is not an athlete. He's wearing his blank on his head.
Athletic supporter.
She said athletic supporter.
I have to tell you, this didn't come out of my mind because I actually saw this on the freeway the other day. A guy was jogging, had long hair.
Yeah.
And to keep that hair out of his head, he had this on his
head. A supporter.
He did. Saw it.
All right. One more jockstrap wins the game.
I guess this is a less refined way of saying athletic supporter. I said jockstrap.
Yeah, of course. That wins the game. What do you have, John? What do they have down here? Show them. Show them down, jockstrap. What is John? Right on the blue dot there. Well, Tom, we've got some prizes for you. We're going to send you a new set of gums and a jar of skunk oil, and some wonderful things will be coming your way. Thank you, Tom Davidson, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Bye. Here you are again. Good luck to you this time. Let's see what we've got for you now. We polled the studio audience, said write down your best answer to this. That's the last blank.
Oh, boy.
That's the last blank. All right. Whom do you want to call on for a little help here?
Okay, Brett.
That's the last straw!
And Charles?
That's the last word.
All right.
And Joyce?
That's the last dance.
Uh-huh.
All right. It is for you, hon.
Dance, word, and straw are the three they've given you. You choose one of those, or do you think up one of your own?
I'm going to go for straw.
Yeah. Straw is what you want. All right. That's the last straw is what she wants. Let's see if it's under the $100 number. The last chance is there. The $250 number says, that's the last time. And the $500 one says, that's the last straw. Congratulations. So another $500 for you. And again, you're in the position of playing for either $5,000 or $10,000, and we're going to let her spin the wheel right after we do a little business with America. All right. Again, Lois Hobby is going to spin the wheel here and see if she's going to play for $5,000 or for $10,000. Good luck to you. Let's step right up here and have a go at it. Well, you got Joyce again. You had her last time, didn't you?
I help me. You do better this time. Think real hard.
All right, here we go. Good luck to you. This is it. Camp blank. Camp blank. All right. Joyce has finished her answer. It's in the slot. Your job is to match her. If you do that, you get $5,000. What do you say?
Camp out.
Camp out. Camp out. What was your second choice?
Well, there's so many different camps. There's Camp Dix, and so I didn't want to pick a name of a camp.
You didn't want to pick a name of a camp,
yeah.
So you just said camp out.
Campfire,
I suppose, would have been a possibility if you were camping out.
I don't like this game anymore.
What'd you say?
I like to win. Campground.
Campground.
It was Camp David,
well, they were,
and Camp Counselor.
Kind of on the same wavelength, but no exact match. Listen, you have a total of $1,000, and our congratulations, and thanks for being with us here on Next Game. Thank you, Lois Hoppe. Bye. Now here comes Elizabeth Augustine and Larry Bowles. Yay! Welcome to the two of you. Nice to have you with us. Larry, tell us about yourself, please.
Well, I'm a minister in the Presbyterian Church in Covina, and I have a wife, two children, Tammy and Paul, and my wife and I enjoy collecting antiques and refinishing antique furniture.
That's interesting work, yes, indeed. All right, Larry, good luck to you. And Elizabeth, tell us about you, please.
I'm a singer-songwriter, and I moved here 2 years ago from St. Paul, Minnesota, so I'm living in Los Angeles, and I'm about to celebrate my birthday and my first year anniversary of marriage.
Congratulations on both counts.
Thank you.
All right, here we go, Larry. A or B?
B.
All right. This is for Larry. Did you hear what happened at the television studio restaurant?
No.
He wants to hear, doesn't he? I guess we better tell him before he gets violent. Well, their special was all you can eat for $5. The Incredible Hulk ate one of the blinks.
This is at a studio restaurant.
Yeah.
Let's say
TV studio
B.
restaurant. All you can eat for $5. One of the blanks. The Incredible Hulk ate one of the blanks. Two to go, five, six. Ready, Larry. Did you hear what happened at the television studio restaurant? Their special was all you can eat for $5. The Incredible Hulk ate one of the blanks.
Plates?
One of the plates. You don't like that. What would you have said? Incredible Hulk ate one of the waiters, according to the audience.
Uh-huh.
What do you say?
Well, when I think that you use the word restaurant, it's more of a commissary is a more accurate
right.
term.
Exactly.
Or a cafeteria.
Right.
And when you follow that, you end up with the steam table.
Steam table.
Yeah.
Right.
If you follow that line of reasoning.
They all have steam tables.
Mm.
Keeps the food tasteless.
Mm.
Yes.
All that little pink jacket brings out the white of your teeth and the gray of your hair. Now, it is not the correct answer, but I do believe it is going to be the popular fave, if you will pardon me. One of the waitresses.
Uh-huh. Good? I think it's good.
Steam table.
We have two steam tables and a waitress.
Funny.
Yeah. All you can eat for $5. The Incredible Hulk ate one of the what?
Oh, I thought you could eat one of the studios.
The whole studio?
Yeah,
wow.
The studio.
I thought of a lot of things he could eat, but since we're dealing with a man of the cloth here,
yeah.
I basically just went for your booth.
Eat? Oh, the booth.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Well, it was genuine leather. That's why I went for it. It wasn't plastic.
Right.
Right. All right, Joyce.
It was also green leather.
Huh.
A booth.
A booth. All right. So, your question will be up in a moment or so, Elizabeth. Now this for you, if you please.
Eat.
It's over. It's all over.
Over.
Until tomorrow.
Friend.
Will you return tomorrow?
Oh, sure.
Oh, thank God.
I think I'm busy.
You'll think about it.
Think about it. I got to check with the password plus.
Have we done something to make you feel insecure, Tom?
Well, you're outdressing me, and it's really burning me up.
I noticed Charles put on a tie there, too. A bow tie. Very nice, Charles.
Yes.
I didn't do this once in a play, so I do it automatically.
Charles can tie a bow tie faster than any human I've ever seen in my life. I got to learn how to do that, Charles. Thank you. Join us next time for the Match Game. I'm Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
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 Today's contestants will also receive the new Shape of Pleasure. Light, sparkling, boldly sophisticated pink champagne takes you away from the ordinary pink champagne malt liquor from Iroquois Brands. And Kraft Macaroni and Cheese Dinner has the cheese taste the kids enjoy. You know they're going to like it. And Hall's Menthol Liptus Cough Tablets. Hall's Vapor Action penetrates deep to help your stuffy nose feel clearer, while Hall's soothes your throat to help you cough. And Bola Beauty Real Roses, the ideal gift treated with patented process that captures their soft, natural look, keeps them lovely for years. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Program is edited for Roger. Wow.